Hello children, here I am going to discuss the today's test, class 9 test, which you have given in Google form. Find out your errors or mistake. Question number 1 is 71 by 2, 81 by 2. So answer is 56, 1 to the power 1 by 2. We know that if a to the power m, b to the power m, that is equals to ab to the power m. So here 7 and 8 in 56 and half. So correct option is b. Next, x minus 1 is factor. That means x minus 1 is 0 and we put x is 1. So by putting 1, the total polynomial will be 0. That means it is k plus 2 is 0. That is k is minus 2. Correct option is C. Now next we go to question number 3. 3 is what? 0 of the polynomial. 0 of the polynomial means we equate the given equation to 0. That means Cx is minus D. X equals to minus D by C. So correct option will be D, minus D by C. Question number 4. Supplementary angles is in the ratio 2x and 7x. We know that supplementary angle sum is 180. That means x is 120, x is 20, and so angles are 2x and 7x, that is 40 and 120. So correct option will be C. Next question 5. 2x minus 5y is 9. Linear equation in two variable. If you put, you see that it has infinite many solution. How many values you are going to put in y, we are getting that values, corresponding values for x. That means there will be infinite solutions. Good. Our correct option will be D. Question number 6. These two lines are parallel. Here it is 43, that means this angle will be 43, alternate angles. And here it is 27 degree, that means by angle sum property, if you find out M, it will be 110 degree. So correct option will be A. A will be correct option. Question number 7. Which of the following is not a parallelogram? Options are rhombus, rectangle, trapezium and square. Except trapezium, all are parallelogram. So here correct option will be trapezium. Question number 8. AB is the diameter. We know the diameter makes on circumference angle 90 degree. And here this angle is given 40 degree. Already you have this. By angle sum property of triangle, if you are using angle sum property of triangle, we have x is 50 degree. That means the correct option will be B, 50 degree. Question number 9. Y equals to mx. Y mx means whatever value you are putting, if x is 0, y will be 0. That means this equation passes through the origin. So passes through D, that is 0, 0. Correct option is D. Question number 10 is question of probability. That pins landed up and pins rest landed down. We don't know total number of pin is 100. Landed up is 73. So if 100 minus 73, that will be 27. That means probability will be 27 by 100, total number of outcomes and how many times it landed up. So correct option is B, 0.27. Question number 11. We know that any arc or chord, if it makes an angle at the center, it is double in the remaining part of the circle. If it makes angle here 36 degree, that means at the center it makes double that. That means it is 72 degree. Correct option is B. Question number 12. Area of colored paper completely cubical box. Cubical box, we know total surface area will be 6A square. So here it's age is X. So it will be 6X square. Correct option is 12. C. Question number 13. Three angles are given. That is 70, 105, 95. You have to find out remaining. We know that angle sum property, sum of quadrilateral angles of a quadrilateral is 360. So we are getting a 90 degree. That means correct option will be A. Question number 14. We go now very quickly. It is base. Here you base hypotenuse of is given. Base is 5, 13, and we know Pythagorean triplet are 12 and 13. So area of triangle you can find out by Pythagoras theorem also, but here as it is 1 mark, so quickly we find out. So area of triangle will be half base into height. Answer is 30 centimeter square. C option is correct. In a histogram, the area of each, it is proportional to frequency of the corresponding class interval. See that 15th. C option is correct. Question number 16. Here BC is the base and exterior angle to exterior angle is 94 and 126. And we have to find out angle A. So what will be angle A? Here it is. We know that exterior angle property sum of both is 180. So 180 minus 126, 180 minus 94, and then we sum of all three angles will be 180. So angle will be C, 40 degree will be correct answer. Question number 17. All of you know how to plot the points. So we see that which point lies on y-axis. So we know that y-axis, which point, if it is abscissa is 0, that means it lies on y-axis. So D option is correct. Which point lies above the x-axis? See that A is 5, 3. Both are positive. First quadrant, both are positive. It lies above x-axis. Minus 4, minus 2 will be here in third quadrant. 0, 0 is origin only, and minus 3, minus 4 also lies in third quadrant. So above x only one is there, which is 5, 3. So A option is correct. The coordinate axis divides into quadrants. So C quadrants is correct answer. All points, if you check, sum is 3 minus 3, 2 minus 5, 5 minus 3, and minus 1 minus 4. All lies in different quadrants. So which option? It is not that A second quadrant, third quadrant, they do not lie in the same quadrant. So D option will be. Question number 18, we start with the case study based questions where it is given as a parallelogram. Parallelogram is given and some properties are there, that opposite sides, if it is parallelogram, opposite angles are equal, opposite sides are equal. So based on that, here one question is, if angle A 115, angle A is here, and angle C you have to find out. So it is also 115 degree. So B, opposite angles are equal. B is AD is 5. If we take like this, AD is 5. That means BC is also 5 centimeter. C is diagonals of a parallelogram bisect each other. So A parallelogram will be correct. D is, we know that diagonals bisect each other. So OA equals to OC will be the correct answer. Question number 19, again case study. where it is volume is given in the ratio 3:4:5, that means 60 x³ is 60, so x is 1, so 3x is 3, that means A3 is the correct answer. Area of four walls, we know 2 into L plus B into H, 2 into 9 into 3, we are getting 54 meters square. Per meter square cost 7.50, so total cost will be B, 405 will be correct answer. All of you know lateral surface area of cuboid is 2 into L plus B into H, as it is given X, Y and Z, so C option will be correct. Area of opposite faces of a cuboid will be equal, so B equal will be correct answer. Question number 20 is probability question. Sum of 3 is 30. So it is 30/500. Total number of outcomes is 500. You divide and find out the answer. 0.06. Sum more than 10 means we take 11 and 12. What is the frequency? 28 and 15. That divided by 500. So it is 0.086. Sum is less than 5, less than equal to 5. That means we take 2, 3 and 4. And it is 86/500. It is 0.02. Between 8 and 12, that means we will not take 8 also, 12 also. So it is 9, 10, 11. So 9, 10, 11 frequency divided by 500. Here we go for 21 question, which is 2 marks question. X is given 1 minus root 2. We find out 1 by x, that is minus of 1 plus root 2. If you simplify, you are getting 2. That means the square will be 4 and B option is correct. Question number 22. Again, lines and angles question. Here, it is given 126 and it is 90. That means it is 36. If these two are 36 and 54 remaining, so here 90, it is 54. So alternate angles also 54. So we have angles 54 and 36. D option is correct. Question number 23 is, you have to find out x as it is 1, 2, 3, 4. Four sides are there. That means sum of all angles is 360. If you find out, suppose this angle is y, it will be 50 degree. So x will be 130 degree. Answer. This angle will be 130 degree. Last question is 24. That is class mark of continuous distribution. It will be false. Answer will be false. So this way we simplify solution solved.